Over the past 6 months, I have been working a lot with a lot of people who are post-concussion, and they've got migraines and nausea, and their fatigue levels are super, super high. So I want to share a little bit with this Facebook Live about how I've been working with them. And I've been working with them both online as well as live and in person in my Calgary studio. So there's some really, really important things that are important. As you know, I talk about yellow lights and whispers. And what I mean by yellow lights and whispers is so often when we are recovering from anything, whether it's concussion or whether it's musculoskeletal or anything, we can get better and we can feel good, right? We definitely know what it's like to feel crappy, but we know what we know we now start to know what it's like to feel good. But because it's a new pattern and a new state, it's not something that has legs, I like to say. It doesn't have endurance. And so this good feeling can then start to fade and it goes into crappy. But the thing is a lot of people don't know the distinction of what actually led them to, from good to crappy. And so they just know that this, and they don't necessarily know how to get back to this. So a big piece of the puzzle is to discover what goes on between the good feeling and the crappy feeling. So said another way is, I say to my clients, so you're feeling good now. Notice when you start to not feel good. That's really, really important. I didn't say notice when you feel crappy. I said notice when you start to not feel good because that's rounding the corner of the state of feeling good. Those are what I call the little whispers. And if you can start to intervene at these little whispers, then you can get back up to feeling good and not come all the way down to feel crappy. Right? So there's this gap between feeling good and feeling crappy, and it's becoming clear about what those things are. And we all have different sensations that let us know, but they're not loud enough. That's why we don't pay attention to them. But when we're in the process of recovery, particularly when it's recovering from a head injury or a concussion, it's really, really important because that fatigue can just set off and just spiral down into emotional to nausea to just like it can you're out flat, right? So a big piece of the puzzle is being able to notice when this piece of feeling good starts to turn into that feeling crappy. So if that is you or you're teaching people with that, see if you can explain that concept. So good to crappy, and then when does that good feeling start to fade, and can you then start to intervene here? Better yet, can you notice what the correlating factors are that contribute to this state of good starting to go down this way? That is a lot of the work that I do with people, is really having them understand that. It could be everything from the environment that's outside, like a super busy schedule, or an extra big load, like really bad weather, or something's happened with a spouse, or I mean, any number of things can create the environment, which then all of a sudden your load is really high, and that can then really drain you and deplete you, and then those sensations start to come up, those really debilitating sensations. So it's a big piece of the puzzle to be able to feel that. Now, what's interesting, and maybe it's not surprising, but a lot of the people that I see who have concussion symptoms and that aren't recovering tend to be people who really are good pushers that tend to drive hard through things. And they can, in prior to them getting the concussion, they were someone who could like take on the world and get the world done. Now, unfortunately, in this recovery process, they can't. It is physically impossible for them to do it, try as they might. So there's a big part of this process which has them have to recognize what their true state is. I'm not going to say limitation because I don't believe it's a limitation. It's what their true state is. And what I consistently emphasize with them is this: your world might feel like it's falling apart, but it's actually not. You're actually getting yourself into a better state, which will better utilize your drive and ambition to support you in actually working better. So you had a way, I'm talking to my client, you had a way of actually doing life, which was likely draining and depleting anyway. You were just really good at putting the gas pedal down and going harder, even if you were depleted. And so now, because you know physically what that feels like, you can now start to shift and adapt according to that. And so when people start to come out of the clouds and come out of that fog, they actually are working better and more effectively than they were even before they got hurt. So I think that's a really, really important and fundamental message for people is that A, you're starting to really understand what the contributing factors are to what's contributing to the fatigue and the nausea when you're, so when you're, from when you're feeling good to when you're feeling crappy, and being able to become aware of that and gaining really good clarity of what those pieces are. Because when you can get awareness there, not only can I help you even more with some of the stimulus that I provide, but you can take that to the people who are helping you. Because in the protocol world of medicine, what ends up happening is, what I've seen anyway, is that people who have X symptoms related to concussion follow this pathway, and people with Y symptoms follow this pathway, and people with Z symptoms follow this pathway, right? That's the pathway of protocol and template. But then there are people who don't fall into those categories, or they fall in between those categories, or they fall into the categories, but there's other factors that are contributing to them not getting better. And then sometimes the people who are following the protocols are kind of like, I don't know what to do with them. And so a big part of what I do that collaborates so well with those protocol-based rehabilitation programs, which are super effective, is that I help them become really, really aware of what all those contributing factors are. So they can then bring that data to their other healthcare providers and say, okay, this is what I'm discovering. This is like, what can you do? Like, because then they take that data, and then the other healthcare professionals can take that data doing what it is that they do really well. And it becomes a really collaborative, integrated process. So you have, might have a physio over here. You might have traditional Chinese medicine over here. You might have an OT over here. You might have me over here. And then collectively, all of what we're doing is working well together, right? And helping that person really elevate to a new state. So the bottom line here that I really want to emphasize and then just finish off with sharing with you is that this is not a game over scenario, that this is really an opportunity to elevate. And I know if you're someone who's watching this and you have concussion or you're post head injury, or you've got someone you love in your life, it might not feel like that at all. I totally get it. And that we can do it step by step in supporting you and supporting your loved one in being able to get to a state of reality about what's really going on physiologically and functionally and anatomically. Help you see some of those whispers that are contributing to your not recovering, and then help you progress forward in concert with the other people that you're working with. Okay, so that's what I found sort of from a nutshell place of supporting someone who's got concussion or head injury and are trying to get themselves back again, and bringing the tools of yoga and awareness of mindfulness and how that brings clarity for everybody on the healthcare team to support them in moving forward. Okay, it's not easy, but it can work. And when it does start to work, the things that shift in your life are really, really cool. Until next time, have fun exploring.